Today I'm going to show you how to turn this stuff into a humidifier for a wooden musical instrument. All the way on the left, we have a bottle of super glue. Right next to that, there is a 1-inch pipe screen used for pipes, smoking pipes. We have rubber cement, an energy drink, and water crystal gels. And underneath it, there's a priority mail envelope that you can get for free from the U.S. Postal Service. That happens to be Tyvek. The gel crystals that I'm using were labeled for smelly jelly, which apparently you can put a scented oil in the water and it will work like potpourri. The crystals themselves don't actually have a smell or a color, which can be added with food coloring if you wanted to do that. The granules on the table are about the size of sugar in the raw. There's a dime there for a size comparison. The smaller the granules are, the faster they absorb water because the absorption rate is relative to the surface area. If you don't have this, you can get it at a garden center or a craft shop. Or if you have a diaper, you can open up a diaper and shake out the cotton and the granules will fall out. The diaper powder is actually even smaller than this. I hoped to get a diaper, but my friends that were gonna bring me one last night forgot to. So this is what we're going with today. So why use crystals? Crystals will absorb a lot of water, and once it's absorbed into the crystal, it cannot leak out. These two shot glasses both started with the same amount of crystals, and as you can see, the volume of water that they can hold is pretty substantial. Some people had some concerns about the speed at which the crystals absorb water, so I thought I would go ahead and do this with water so you can see how fast it absorbs. This will not be speeded up. And I am using hot water because it just works faster. When it hits the top, I'm gonna have to stop this because I probably put too much water and it will continue to rise and probably be above the rim. But you get a sense of how fast it actually does absorb water, and it is pretty quick. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is drink your energy drink. And after you do that, you wanna remove the outside plastic in one piece by sliding it off the bottle. We're gonna reuse the plastic, so that's going to be important, so don't throw that away and try to get it out without tearing it. What you're going to do next is flatten the plastic wrap and cut the bottom and the top off so that you have a flat tube. You're going to want the edges to be very clean so that they don't tear. Then you're going to make the label on the left look like the label on the right by heating it on the bottle. I'm gonna use an electric stove today because that's what I have. If you don't have an electric, you could probably do it on a gas or maybe a candle or a lighter or something. Anyway, you wanna leave the sleeve just a little bit over the edge because this part's gonna shrink in around the edge of the bottle. When you start to do it, it might shrink unevenly, but if you keep going, it'll even itself out. So let's go ahead and show you that. Okay, we're gonna need some Tyvek circles. Now, these envelopes you can get for free at the post office near the automated shipping kiosks. You're gonna trace the bottom of the bottle and cut it out with a pair of scissors. So now you should have some Tyvek circles that are the right size as the bottom of the bottles. The first one I'm gonna show you has a screen glued to the bottom of the bottle. So all the way on the left, I have a 5/8 inch hole drilled through the bottom of the bottle. And then I've taken a 1 inch pipe screen and glued it onto the bottom with super glue. Next to that, we have our pre-cut Tyvek circle. And next to that, we have our outside label that is shrunk to fit correctly. When you put it together, it's gonna look like this. The Tyvek circle is not glued on, it is just sandwiched between the outer label and the bottom of the bottle. What this will do for you is that you can fill up your bottle without the label and the Tyvek on. That way, once you turn it upside down, you know that no water can ever really leak out because you've just strained off any extra water. The Tyvek circle will give you a water barrier because although the gel does hold the water, it can leak water by contact. So what the Tyvek will do for you is create a barrier that will let the water vapor dry out, but will not let water out of the bottle. In the second example, I've drilled a 1 inch hole through the bottom of the bottle, and then I've used the rubber cement to glue the Tyvek circle onto the bottom of the bottle. And then I put some more rubber cement on the outside of the disc and then the outside of the bottle and rubber cemented the outside label to both the bottle and the Tyvek circle. So there's a seal between the bottle and the Tyvek and a seal between the label and the top of the Tyvek. This would be if you don't have a pipe cleaner and don't want to go that route, and you just want to fill up your bottle, give it a couple minutes before you put it in, and then hope that nothing leaks. Once you've got your bottle made and full of the gel, you can just stick it between the strings of your guitar so that the opening to the bottle is inside the body, which should probably give you the best humidity, I think. So you just spread the middle two strings, place your bottle in, and the cap will hold it between the strings. It doesn't actually really move around. The strings will hold it pretty securely. It's not really sliding or anything. And it seems to be pretty secure.